Just take three relaxing breaths. And then you just put one arm underneath the scapula and one arm here at the hip and just stretch. Feel okay, Julie? Compressions. Start off with number one, effleurage. Number two, trapezius effleurage. Number three, we're going to crisscross effleurage. Turn the hand effleurage. Fan hand effleurage. And then reinforce circles. Heel of the hand you're using into the lower back and upper glutes and into the hip. Really focusing in with your fingers round about the scapula. And then we're going to repeat those three to the other side. Maintain contact. Okay, I'll take my hand effleurage. Do that three times. Fan hand effleurage. Again, three times. And then reinforce circles. going to do a hands-free technique using the ulna. I'm going to do sawing. Thumb frictions into rectus spinae. Just roll your thumbs up very slowly. Again, do this 3 times. Thumb frictions into rectus spinae. Followed by kneading. So kneading the lower back, going into the thoracic area, just the mid back. Okay, back down to the lower back. And single-handed kneading into the lower back. Back into double-handed kneading. Kneading the shoulder. Then going into your percussion, tapamo. So you're hacking first, lighter at the kidney area, onto the glutes, lighter again, harder again. Pounding. And then back into your kneading. Kneading the neck. Single-handed. And then double-handed. that to the other side. Okay, so midi, lower back, so that's the lumbar area, into the mid back, which is the thoracic area, up to the shoulder. Back down to the lumbar. Put your hands in just at the piriformis. Single-handed kneading, lower back. Double-handed, back up to the shoulder. And then single-handed kneading into the neck area. Or you can do double-handed kneading as well. Okay, then it's thumb frictions beginning at the bottom of the back. So start at the lumbar. You're using alternate thumb frictions. Start medially, so the middle of the back, and work out to the side of the back, which is called lateral. So medial to lateral, and then back into medial. Up to the back of the thoracic area. Okay, when you want to work the top of the shoulder, get to the top of the bed, take your stance up to the top of the bed, and then work right in at the top of the trapezius there. And then right in between the scapula, so on the rhomboid, so just taking your thumbs down alternately. Right in between the scapula. You're really pressing down and compressing any adhesions that you can find. Okay, and then just smooth with alternate hands. Okay, we'll do the same at the other side. So we'll commence with alternate thumb frictions at the lower back. Medially, come in like about laterally. Again, take your body to the top of the couch so you can get into the top of the trapezius. And then rolling alternate thumbs in between the scapula. Okay, next we're going to do some hands-free techniques again. It's more deep tissue. I'm going to use this part of your arm here, which is I call the rolling pin. You hold your wrist, you start at the lower back, you're in a walking stance, and you just roll your forearm up. Obviously you can't put too much pressure here because this is a kidney area. So just rolling up. A bit more pressure now that you're on the rib cage. As you get to the scapula, you want to turn your arm. Bring your hands forward and continue on with your forearm. Taking your elbow gently into the top of the trapezius. Come around the shoulder, slot in and come down the arm. So do that three times. So this is a rolling pin. What we're going to do now is petrissage with the rolling pin as well. Drawing friction circles with your forearm. This is particularly nice around the scapula. From there, that's when you go into elbow work. This is your two deep tissue techniques where you're able to get right in to the muscular fibres, break down any knots or adhesions, and it is very firm pressure for the client as well. With it causing you too much stress, actually, it's good. Now I'm going to go into my elbow. Okay, so you pop your elbow just in those tension nodules here. So I'm just going to put my elbow in here. Put my hand on my shoulder just to protect my one arm so it's not flapping about. Just place it on here. Then place your hand just at your own elbow. You make sure it doesn't slip and hit into the vertebrae, and then draw circles, friction circles with your elbow. Does that feel okay? Just yelp if it's sore. So elbow works really good if a client's got a lot of tension and your thumbs can't quite penetrate the tension. Then the elbow's good, But obviously you can't feel as much in the elbow yourself as you would your thumbs, so you just need to be really careful in how much pressure you're putting on. It's good for the top of the trapezius, right into the shoulder. And you can go back out your forearms again, so you can just mix it up a bit. Nice stretch and air flash technique as well, using the forearms. Okay, and then we'll repeat that to the other side. Okay, so forearm, rolling pin, start from the base of the back, taking it up. When you get to the scapula, this angle here, turn it. Bring your back foot forward, press and slide. Come down the arm. And again. Petrissage or circular motion with your rolling pin. And then again onto elbow work. So remember to place your hand on your shoulder, hold the elbow to guide the circular frictions with the elbow around the scapula. And a nice view of the lash just to finish that off, using your hands free again. And knuckling. And take that knuckling right into the neck. Alternatively, you can do knuckling from the top of the couch, and you can knuckle the lower back. And then begin to bring that up. Reverse effilage, 3 times. And then what we're going to do is the neuromuscular technique. So you start at the occipital. Place both thumbs either side of the occipital. Draw your thumbs down to T1. And then draw your thumbs out over the top of the trapezius. Maintain that pressure and then come back in the bay and just follow the shape of the scapula around to the underarm. So we're going to do this light, medium and heavy. Take your thumb all the way down to the axillary node and sweep back up and do this 3 times. Starting just at this bone here, T1. So you can take your thumbs, engage your thumbs right into the muscle, and then stroke out towards the bone. So this is another neuromuscular technique. So sink in, press, slide. Press in, hold and slide. I'm just going to keep continue to do this right down to the bottom of the spine scapula. Start to friction right into the thoracic area and shoulder area, pushing the shoulders down and using the palmar surface of the hands to knead in between the scapula. Come to the side of the client, I'm going to do some ringing. Squeezing and releasing, so just open the skin, stretch it even, stretch the skin, and then squeeze. It's a nice lymphatic drainage movement. braking takes all the waste toxins to the nearest lymph node. Feathering stimulates the nerve endings, brings the plank back round. And I'm just going to finish off with myofascial release. And again, it's just like the rolling pin effect, where what we're going to do is stretch the muscle tissue and fascia. It's the very last technique that you would use, because you want to stretch the fascia without pegging the tissue back by doing anything stimulating, so you've just got to do a nice stretching technique to finish. So just using the forearm, your stance is in the backwards position. And it's just like the rolling pin, except you're doing it a lot slower and a bit more deeper. So this is good for chronic pain conditions. Okay, you're going to turn your arm again. Bring your back foot forward. Lean down and continue. Again, it is, it's deep tissue again. And you literally just come off really, really slowly. Keep your hand on, repeat to the other side. Then take the towel back up and you want to finish just how you started. Okay, you just take your legs and breathe in and out.